The old Adamsville Recreation Center was the site of a recent Women's History Month event. Several groups and individuals entertained and educated the audience. The wives of two civil rights activists, the late Reverend Joseph Boone and the late James Orange, spoke to the crowd about their husband's involvement in the civil rights movement. The mother of Mayor Kasim Reed was also on hand to speak to the audience. Performers from City of Atlanta Voices and Najuma entertained the crowd with traditional song and dance. March is Women's History Month and is celebrated worldwide to honor the contributions of women throughout history. The APD's Mobile Community Oriented Police Station, or MCOPS, was recently in sight and on hand in the Pittsburgh community. The mobile station is part of the Atlanta Police Department's Community Liaison Unit, which focuses efforts on community policing by engaging neighborhood residents. The APD puts a heavy emphasis on community engagement to gain the trust of residents. Officer Eric Escalante believes the efforts are paying off.
Slowly but surely, we're getting the trust of the people just from the way they interact with us. They actually want to talk to us, and they feel like it's working for them.
Last year, Channel 26 accompanied an officer from the Community Liaison Unit as he worked his beat in the Pittsburgh community. Everyone we spoke to said seeing APD officers engaging residents in casual conversation has helped them to see the police in a new light. Mayor Reed recently made a stop at the J.D. Sims Recreation and Community Center. The mayor was there to see a special performance from the children who attend the Culture Club after-school program there. The kids were joined on stage by members of the Alvin Eiley American Dance Theater, who taught them some new techniques. The programming at J.D. Sims ties back to Mayor Reed's Centers of Hope initiative, which aims to make Atlanta's rec centers a place for the city's youth to gather, learn, and stay safe from bad influences.
It's wonderful to see this going on in Atlanta. And when you see these young people, this is not just about dance. This is giving them a brighter future in a way, because they have hope for a better future when they believe in something larger than themselves.
Members of the Atlanta Police Department took time out of their day to donate blood in memory of a fallen officer. Officer Gail Thomas was laid to rest in February. Thomas was struck and killed by a drunk driver as she got out of her patrol car to assist another officer doing a routine traffic stop. In memory of their fallen comrade, the APD held a memorial blood drive. Some of those who donated blood during the drive said it was the best way to honor one of their own.
Gail Thomas will always be a very special person to me, and it was a pleasure working with her, and she always talks about her daughter, so I keep that fond memory of her.
It's something I've always done. My mother's always said, donate, 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 whether it be money, blood, or your organs. Mm-hmm. So it's really just a moral view that I have. Donating, if we can make it, why not give to those that can't?